60s. Come up with a solution. Okay?
Not necessarily a veto or...
He doesn't have to veto. No.
So he just has
it's not a bill.
It's not a bill, it's just a resolution.
It's a, I think it's a memorandum.
Memorandum. So he can give it back to the
SEC. He can give it back and say, looks, I appointed you there to solve the problem. Okay, come up with a solution.
So you suggest that he does that?
I don't know. I mean, that's if I were the president, I would do that. Okay, thank I you. Appointed you there specifically to come up with a solution. You manage a private fund. Okay. Mine is a private fund.
Thank you, Secretary.
Cedric?
Sir, I think you mentioned this already, pero i-follow ko na rin, sir. So you agree, sir, yung ibang recommendations or suggestions to reform yung collection, yung cuts on bonuses?
There are many things that you can do, right? I sympathize with the pension funds right now. As you know, the interest rates are so low, it's difficult to make money. Right? Can you imagine, many years ago, the interest rate was around 10%, right? Now, the interest rates will be around maybe 3, 4%. It's difficult to make money. So they have to economize, they have to be prudent, etc. I think, all right, I think I've said enough.
Sir, pwede na ba mag-other matter?
Sure. SS muna tayo. Henry Uri, to be followed by JP. Henry.
Secretary, good morning. Another topic lang, yung sa Senator Lacson keep on saying that there is still a pork barrel. If I may ask, ano ho ba ito? Paano ba ninyo ito sinasagot? And then, pangalawang tanong ho, sa 2017 budget, I saw that we have still unprogrammed funds, which was the subject of the criticism of the past. Para saan din po yung unprogrammed funds, Secretary?
Let me answer the second question. Unprogrammed funds are there to cover some eventuality. Like, for example, if you have a loan which is almost complete, but it's not in yet, then you can put some appropriations there. And you can use only the unprogrammed fund, which is in the nature of a standby allocation, if you have more money than what you originally anticipated. Okay? Now, on the second question, is there a pork barrel? You know, the Supreme Court is very clear. The definition of that is that congressmen and senators meddle with the implementation of projects. In other words, they would have, as if they have a right to a chunk of money in the budget. Let's say merong 200 billion doon, sila yung mag-identify. That's not allowed. And that's not in the in this budget. As you know, I'm one of the petitioners against DAP and PDAF, okay? So as I said, this budget and future budgets will be compliant with the two Supreme Court decisions. Okay? That's why I have also filed a budget reform bill, so that after us, maybe the next president or next presidents will try to honor the Supreme Court decision, okay?
Thank you, Henry. Right, my apologies, Cedric.
Sir, on ASEAN hosting, sir, there are reports that apparently there was a shortcut on the bidding process of the 2.8 billion ASEAN hosting deal, sir. Your reaction, sir?
Thank you. You asked that question. Again, before the end of the day, I'll give you the details of that. Right, it's being typed right now. You know, ASEAN is this year, so we have to act with dispatch, right? And there's a part of the project which is a part of the 15 billion allocation for that has been bidded out, but we complied with all these steps. Okay, now only one bidder submitted a bid. This is the same bidder who won the right to provide a service in the 2015 APEC. Now, Ian, did not even submit a bid. So I'm surprised that he's now complaining. And he cannot really comply with, because the kind of services that he is providing is very limited. The total budget for that service that was bid out was 2.9 billion. You know how much the winning bidder bid? 1 billion. Ayaw pa ba natin yun? 2.9 nga yung estimate ni Ambassador Paynor. Ito, nag-bid siya ng 1 billion. And the same bid that he submitted 2 years ago because of the APEC. So talagang hindi ko maintindihan why the press gave him the space, no? At nakataon pa naman, holiday, wala akong matawagan opisina, sarado opisina namin. So it's really a hassle, no? Hindi nga sa qualified magbid. And in fact, he did not bid. All right?
Sir, you only one bidder, wala pong irregularity sa ganun, sir?
Oh, walang bid. If there's like one qualifying bid, that's a valid. Hindi failure yan.
So the final price is 2.8, yung project?
No, the estimate is 2.9. Okay. 2.88. Ang bid nung nanalo is 1. So sabi ko ngayon, ibigay nyo na. Bigay nyo na. Kaya lang pala sila hindi nila binigay kasi naantay nila yung 2016 budget, and which is effective today. No? So sabi ko, bigay nyo na. For ignore that EUN complaint.
Okay. Thanks, sir.
JP?
Hi, sir. Sir, follow-up lang dun sa ASEAN question. Mm-hmm. Sir, the company was some kind of insinuating na the reason why the process was shortcutted, kasi daw po, goods yung dineclare na PBD, Philippine Bid Document sa PILGEPS, when it should be categorized as consulting services, which would take a longer time period, sir. What's your reaction?
Actually, it's a combination of goods plus technical, all right?
Yes,
plus technical. Ang point nung EON, which is a smaller company, is dapat break up into 5 para mag-qualify sa doon sa isa sa technical. Kasi ano naman yan is, ano he said, parang party provider lang siya, di ba? Ganun. So ang may ayaw yung si Ambassador Paynor. Kasi he doesn't want to talk to 5 people, di ba? Isa lang dapat. So yun ang kasi kung i-break up mo yung contract, if you break it up into 5 small projects, magka-qualify yung iyon doon sa one of the 5. Kasi we're running out of time already. Napaka ano na yung schedule Ngayon na mangyayari na yan ngayon There will be a meeting na sometime January, no? So there's really a sense of urgency. So sabi niya, no, we should just have one bidder. I want to talk to one person. So yun ang nangyari doon. Small company lang tong iyon
Yes po. Oo. Sir, follow up lang doon po sa...
And there's a ruling by, you know, the structure there is, there's a GPPB. This is the General Procurement Board, no, which sets the policy. And there's the Procurement Service. The Procurement Service is the implementation arm. The GPPB is the policy board, no? And sabi ng policy board, mayroon na siyang decision, pwede yun. Ganun.
Sir, last na lang po dun sa take-home pay. Yung specifics po dun, sir, yung increase is on the basic salary or allowances?
Combination. Okay, salary and because of that quirk na pag tinaas mo yung basic pay ng militar, taas lahat, pati yung mga pensioners. Ayaw naman natin yun, di ba?
So mostly, sir, talaga.
But in the case of the soldiers and the policemen, combination, you know.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, Raymond Tenasa. Microphone. Cedric, pabot ng microphone. Thank you.
Sir, going back lang sa SSS, kasi parang, please check me if I got the wrong feel from you, na parang sinabi niyo na hindi dapat bineburden ang Pangulo with this pension. Pero ang lumalabas ngayon, pati parang sa klamo, sentimiento is, naipangako kasi ng Pangulo mismo So parang nandun lang gagaling. Yung parang panunumbat ng iba na naipangako mo. So parang ganun. So,
well, hindi man ako politiko, but I know that there's President Duterte and there's President Duterte. And talagang iba yung candidate Duterte sa President Duterte. And you see that all over, even worldwide. Iba yung candidate Trump versus President Trump, no? May napapangako ka na pagka natingnan mo yung datos, hindi pala pwede. So yun, doon ako nang gagaling, no? And that I'm just making a recommendation na historically hindi talaga ginagawa yun. You don't burden the taxpayers to support a private fund. Okay? And then.
Kasi siguro din po, nandyan kayo para at least.
Kaya nga eh. I mean, I'm just doing my job. No? Kung mag-decide siya na otherwise, I have done my job. Diba?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, Benji Liwanag, last question.
Sir, good morning. On SSS. Sir, is one of your recommendations yung tanggalin na yung malalaking bonuses and perks na nakukuha ng mga boss na sa SSS? May kasama ho ba sa recommendation?
Ay, hindi ko nire-recommend yun. I just, principle lang yun na don't use the taxpayers' money to support a private fund. Okay? Fund ho ninyo yun eh.
Yes,
fund
yes,
ninyo.
Yeah.
Okay? Why should you use the taxpayers' money knowing that there are some taxpayers na wala nga silang trabaho eh. Diba? Alam mo ba yung sinasite ni, I think I overheard si Congressman, the former Congressman, no? Sinasabi niya, ito yung workforce, no? Hindi niya ba alam na one-third of the workforce are farmers and fisher folks? One-third. So kung meron kang 40 million doon, one-third noon mga farmers, ang hirap mangolekta doon, ha? And then, ang laking part din ng employed workforce, walang sweldo po. Nakalagay doon, unpaid family workers. Yun ang talagang datos eh. Pag nagtrabaho ka sa sari-sari store ng pamilya nyo, o kaya yung car wash business, wala ka naman sweldo eh. But under the law, under the statistics, employed ka. Kaya may misnomer yung ganong na ang dami-dami namang workers eh, dapat nang olekta. May hindi to ganong kadali mangolekta. No? But you know, kaya ho may board ang bawat GSIS, SSS, they should do their job. They should do their job.
Mahirap na pong mangolekta, but ang isa dun sa recommendation nyo, taasan yung sisingilin dun sa...
Yung mga formal workers po ito.
Formal workers. Like us.
Oh. Yeah. Ang ano ho, kasi nun, because of the tax reform, mangyayari niyan, you will have more money in your pockets. So, konting-konti lang naman yung i-increase sa inyo. Siguro naman na-afford ninyo.
Tatanggalin po ba yung 20% discount dun sa mga senior?
Bago na yan, ha? Bagong issue yan. As far as the 20% on medicine, alam ko, protektado ho yan. No? Protektado ho yan. And then, meron silang dinidevise na parang you have to discriminate between rich seniors and poor seniors. Meaning, kasi, di ba, meron hong privilege na 20% discount kung whether you're rich or poor, di ba? Sino ba naman nakaka-afford na magpupunta ka sa 5-star hotel na 20%, di ba? Mga ganun. So, ang gagawin na, tatargetin na ho yun, na kung if you're poor, then you'll be given something like a CCT, yung conditional cash transfer. Cash talaga, ibibigay sa inyo. In lieu of that privilege, no?
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. Salerina, ito na daw yung last.
Pero ano po yun, ha? Hindi, it will be submitted to Congress. It's up to Congress to decide.
Salerina.
Sir, clarification lang. You have mentioned na ipapass if ever dun sa board ng SSS. Pero hindi ba ang effect ng joint resolution? It's like a bill na pag naglapse in, pag hindi inakta ng president, it would lapse into law within 30 days, after 30 days.
Ano po yan? Yung
joint resolutions ng SS para sa SSS hike po.
Sino nagpasa ng joint resolution?
It's the lower house and the Senate po.
Tapos na ho yun eh.
Oho,
tapos,
pero di ba it's with the president already. So you have mentioned that...
Hindi, ang nakipresidente is a memo from the Board of Trustees of SSS. Wala pong joint resolution. Yung kay President Duterte?
Oho, pero nasa na po yung joint resolution? Di ba yung memo nyo?
Na-veto ho yun. Na-veto ho ni Pinoy yun.
Yeah. No, that was a bill during the time of Pinoy. But under the Duterte administration, I believe it was, there was this joint resolution.
Wala pong joint resolution na nakipresidente ngayon. Wala pong.
Pero sorry, yung nasa press release ng DBM, it's not DBM, the DOF, it said, that was last week, it said that the recommendation to increase the contribution of the members was based on the joint resolutions of the Senate and the House of Representatives. Hmm. And you were one of those who signed that memo.
I might be wrong. Hindi, alam ko walang joint resolution. Kasi pinag-uusapan pa yun hanggang ngayon sa Congress.
Okay, thank you. Ace Romero? Last na